हाय फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज सुदीप चंदन एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल एनर्जी एंड एनवायरनमेंट एजुकेशन। टुडेज वीडियो इज बेसिकली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर दोज एस्पिरेंट्स हु आर लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू अपीयर इन दिस ईयर्स एनर्जी मैनेजर और एनर्जी ऑडिटर्स एग्जाम, और मे बी दे आर विलिंग टू गो फॉर इट इन द कमिंग ईयर्स। सो बेसिकली टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर सेवन इंपॉर्टेंट टिप्स फॉर बीडब्ल्यूईज एनर्जी मैनेजर्स और एनर्जी ऑडिटर्स एग्जाम, एंड दिस टिप्स आर बेसिकली based on my personal experience. So I hope if you follow these tips, this may help you to prepare for your exams in this year or in coming years. So to start with, let's see the content first. Friends, basically I'm going to start with an overview of energy manager, energy auditor exam. This will be followed by the books that you need basically to prepare for this exam. Also I'm going to give an overview of question papers, and would like to explain you some myths and facts that you need to know, need to understand before you appear for this exam, and also some important tips that may help you out based on my personal experience that may help you out to prepare for this exam. So friends, I would like to request you to watch this video, and if you feel it's really helping you or it may help you, please to share with your colleagues, your friends who are also trying to prepare for this exam in this year, or maybe they are looking forward to have this exam, sit for this exam in the coming years. And also do subscribe my channel, friends. This is my personal request. So let's see the overview of energy manager and energy auditor exam. Basically this is very important, friends. If you are applying for this exam, there are a lot of candidates whose application gets rejected because they are not aware of the eligibility criteria. So basically you need to understand the eligibility criteria for this exam. There are basically two types of eligibility criteria, for one for the energy manager exam, the other one is for energy auditor exam. So for the energy manager's exam, if you want to appear, so there are basically five criteria that you need to understand, you need to follow, and if you fall under this one of these criteria, well then you are eligible to sit for the exam. The first criteria is that you should be a graduate engineer, that is BE or BTech, and you should have at least 3 years of work experience. This work experience basically is for those who are working in energy sector. Only those people can appear for this exam. Apart from this, if you are a postgraduate engineer, that is master's in engineering or master's in technology or equivalent, and at least you should have 2 years of experience basically in the energy sector, then you are eligible to appear for this exam. Thirdly, like suppose a graduate engineer with postgraduate degree in management, if you have done MBA or something in energy sector or equivalent, with at least 2 years of work experience in energy sector, well, then you can be eligible to appear for the exam. Fourth, it is that if you are a diploma holder and if or equivalent with at least 6 years of experience in energy sector, then you are eligible to sit for this exam. And the fifth one is if you are postgraduate in physics or electronics or chemistry with physics and mathematics at graduation level with 3 years of work experience at least in the energy sector, then you are eligible to sit for this energy manager's exam. Likewise, for the energy auditor's exam, if you want to appear for a certified, if you want to become a certified energy auditor, then you have to be eligible for at least one of the three criteria that I'm going to list out here. The first one is a graduate engineer. I mean, you need to be BTech or BE or equivalent with at least 3 years of experience in energy sector, then you are eligible to sit for this exam. Also, if you are a postgraduate engineer, that is master's of engineering and or master of technology, MTech or equivalent, with at least 2 years of work experience in the energy sector, then you are eligible to sit for this exam. And last, if you are a graduate engineer with postgraduate degree in management or equivalent with at least 2 years of experience involving use of energy in operation, that is maintenance planning, that is basically experience in energy sector, then you are eligible to sit for this BW's energy auditors exam. So please do, friends, check it out whether you are eligible or not before you apply for the exam. Otherwise your application is going to be rejected, and it will be a wastage of your money, and also it will be a wastage of your time, which is very precious. Now let's see the examination papers. Basically, friends, if you are appearing for the energy manager exam, so you need to qualify the first, second and third paper. And if you are appearing for the energy auditors exam, so you need to clear all the four papers, first, second, third and fourth. The examination for the first three papers will be of 3 hours duration, and the fourth paper is of 2 hours. The maximum marks for the first three papers are 150, and the fourth paper is of 100 marks. So basically, if you want to clear the first three papers for energy management exam, so at least you need to have 50%, that is 75 marks out of 150 you need to obtain if you want to clear each paper for energy management exam. For the energy auditors exam, the fourth paper you need to also clear along with the first three papers, which will be of 100 marks. At least you need to get 50 marks out of 100 if you want to clear the energy auditors exam. Now, as far as the examination centers are concerned, basically examination centers are located in every region across the country and covers the major cities like Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Bhopal, Bhubaneswar, Chandigarh, Chennai, and so on. So basically you are given three choices of examination center in the order of preference. So basically, if the number of applicants for a particular center is found to be less than the minimum required, then the center can be shifted. So basically, like suppose if your choice is, the first choice is Jaipur, for example, the second choice is Chandigarh, and the third choice is Delhi NCR. Now suppose in case of Jaipur, where you have given your first choice, if the candidates are less, then the center can be shifted automatically to Chandigarh. And if suppose Jaipur and Chandigarh, both the centers are having less candidates for appear, so basically your choices can be automatically shifted to Delhi NCR. So you have to select the choice accordingly such that it falls under your region. Now let's look at the books for preparation, I mean which books you should refer for the preparation of this particular exam. Basically friends, BEE gives you their own books which are based on their own format. That a book has to be referred for preparation of exam. Basically there are four books. The first book is General Aspects of Energy Management and Energy Audit, which covers basically chapters on energy management, energy audit, energy scenario, energy action planning, and so and so. And the second book is basically the Energy Efficiency Thermal Utilities. Basically in this book you will be reading chapters based on boilers, steam systems, furnaces, heat exchangers, waste heat recovery, etc. The third book basically deals with energy efficiency electrical utilities. In this you will be going through the chapters basically which are like electrical system, motors, compressors, pumps, fans, blowers, light rings, etc. And the last and the fourth book basically covers the energy performance assessment for equipment and utility systems. In this book basically the chapters will be based on the extracted part from the first three books. I mean this particular book deals with numerical part extracted from different chapters among the first three books, and also contains chapters with energy performance assessment in different sectors, basically like cement, textile, power plant, steel, etc. So this is the fourth book that you will be given to read and to understand for the preparation of the BEE's energy managers and energy auditors exam. So first three books basically are important for the energy managers exam. The last book will help you for the energy auditors exam. But even if you're preparing for the energy managers exam, you can refer the last book for the fourth book. This will help you to prepare for the numericals for the energy managers or energy auditors exam. Now let's see the overview of question papers. As I said, the first three papers are basically for energy manager exam, and the fourth paper is basically for the energy auditors exam. So the first three papers will have three sections. Basically, the first section of the examination paper will be based on the objective type questions. The second section will be of short type questions, and the third section will be of long type questions. So these are the three sections that are covered in the first paper, second paper, and the third paper for the energy managers exam. And now if you are preparing for the energy auditors exam, you'll have to face the fourth paper. The fourth paper will have also three sections. The first section will be of brief questions, basically objective types. Second section will be of short numerical questions, and the third section will be of long numerical questions. So basically the fourth paper is more or less on numerical side, that have which covers the most more questions on numerical aspects. So when preparing for the fourth exam, you basically prepare for the numerical sort of questions. Now this is very important friends. Let's see the myths and facts which you need to know, which you need to understand if you are appearing for this year's exam, or maybe if you are looking forward to have prepare for the exams in coming years. So there are some myths which are in our mind which you may heard may ha have heard from somebody or somewhere else. So these myths need to be cleared, and the facts also you need to know. So let's see the myths and facts first, friends. So the first myth, high technical knowledge required. A lot of people, especially friends, believe that only you should have high technical knowledge if you want to prepare for the exam. This is a complete myth, friends. Even if you have basic understanding on the subject matter, and if you read, if you study conceptually, then also you can crack this exam easily, friends. So this is a myth and this is a fact. Secondly, is also I mean, a lot of people believe that only those people who are into energy audit background, those people only should sit for the exam. Others should not sit for the exam. Friends, basically, there are different profiles in energy sector. Like suppose someone is in renewables, some are in energy, some are in, I mean, others profiles in energy sector. So everyone can appear for the exam. Energy audit, fact is that energy audit is just a part of it. There are other aspects also which are covered in this exam. So even if you are into renewables or any other profiles in energy sector, and if you have really a bit of basic understanding, and if you have, if you read the books thoroughly, and also if you have conceptual study, you can crack the exam easily. The third myth is basically books are too bulky to cover. I mean, when you get the books, you have four books in your hand. So basically, there are a lot of people who get I mean, frightened to just seeing the books. They feel that these are too bulky to cover, and they will not be able to cover the entire syllabus in the allotted time, and they will not be able to crack the exam. This is a completely myth, my friends. If you really prepare in a systematic approach, if you take to cover the syllabus easily, you can cover the syllabus, and you can easily read all the books, and you can easily crack the exam. The fourth myth is we'll need to take at least 1 or 2 months leave. So basically, a lot of people are professionals who are already working somewhere in any company, in any other any organization. So they are willing to go for this exam, but they feel that suppose if you want to sit for the exam and read all the books, so they have to take leaves for at least 1 or 2 months, which is not I mean, they will not be able to go for it. So they somehow do not sit for the exam or do not appear for the exam. And but the fact is you do not take any leave for this exam. Even if you have a proper strategy, if you have a proper strategy for this exam, there will no leave required, and you can easily crack this exam, friends. This is the fourth myth and the fact. The fifth and last one which I need to share is there are a lot of people who feel that in one go they can crack the exam. Now friends, this is a complete myth, and they feel that if they will not be able to crack in one go this, then again then they won't be able to qualify in next year or for this exam. So friends, this is a complete myth. This completely depends on your how you plan it out and your capability. If you feel that you can clear all the three papers for energy managers, all the four papers for energy auditors, definitely you should go for all the four papers in one go. But if you feel that it's not possible for me to crack all the four papers, clear all the four papers or all the three papers energy auditor managers exam, so basically you can go for at least 1 or 2 papers in the first year, and clear the other two papers in the second year or the next year. So it depends on your capability or on your how you plan it out. So there's no need to fear it out if you have cleared only one paper, if you so you will not be able to clear the papers in the coming years, or you should clear all the four papers in only one go. So these are the facts, I mean friends, and these are the myths and these are the facts which I wanted to share to you, such that you prepare, you make yourself ready for the exam in a better way. So the tips, friends. The first tip which I need to share, I mean which I want to share with you based on my personal experience, read the chapters thoroughly. Read and read. The more you read, the more understanding you will have on different chapters in different books. So I would suggest you read a number of times you feel like, I mean completely go through the chapters. Do not be so technical, do not think too much, just you read the books like a study. You can download the all the paper chapters in your mobile, on your laptop, whenever you get time, whenever you travel, whenever you feel like reading, just go through the chapters, different chapters. But do not think too much, just read. The more you read, the more you will have better understanding of different chapters, and you will have better hold on these chapters. And the number of times you read, you will feel more comfortable, more involved, and it will feel more interesting for you to understand these chapters. And this is the first tip that I want to share with you, friends. So the second tip, basically, friends, what I will suggest is to you focus on objectives. I mean, focus on objective-based questions. Friends, if you see the question paper, basically the first three papers, you'll have at least 50 number of questions which are objective questions. And if you see the total marks, it is of 150 marks. So out of 150, 50 marks is of objective questions. And if you see the marks which you need to qualify, that is 75 marks you need to obtain to clear all the three papers. So basically, if you get at least 50 or at least 45 plus, if you get in each paper, so the remaining only you need to have 25 to 30 marks you need to obtain from other subject type or numerical based questions. So basically, focus on objectives and try to get at least 45 to 50 marks from these objectives in each paper, first, second and third. So this will help you out to at least clear the exam without investing too much time on numericals or other subject type based questions. The third tip is basically, friends, to jot down all the formulas. You list all the formulas from different chapters. If you go through the chapters, you see that in each chapter basically you'll have certain formulas. You note down all the formulas in one notebook. These formulas will help you in two ways, friends. Basically, when you go for the numericals part of the questions paper, so there also these formulas, if you jot down and you learn all those formulas by heart, all these formulas, this will help you to solve the numericals for the numerical based questions. And also, if you see the objective type questions, there are a lot of questions which are only formula based. So if you have the formula on your tips, so straight away you can solve all these formula based objective type questions also. So these formulas will help you out not only for the long type numerical based questions, also for your objectives and also for your short type questions, where only formula you need to put and you get the answers solved easily. So basically, I'll suggest you this will be my third tip, that you jot down all the formulas in one notebook and by heart all those formulas. And this will really help you when you prepare for the exams. When you sit for the exam, this will really help you to solve the questions, either in numerical based questions or for the short type based questions, and definitely for the objective type questions, where only you need to apply these formulas and solve it out, and you get the questions correct. The fourth tip, friend, basically I would suggest you to refer last at least 5 years questions banks. Although the questions they change in different exams year to year, but maximum questions rotates. The lot of questions which you see that if you solve 5 year questions, you have a number of questions which are repeated. So I would suggest you to refer last 5 years questions, or if you have time, then you can at least go for 10 years questions. But if you have not too much time, at least 5 years question you solve it out. You will get this will help you to better understand the question pattern, the chapters that you should refer, and the part of the chapters which you should focus. Those things also you will get understanding if you refer the last 5 years question bank. So the fourth tip will be, friends, at least solve 5 years question bank if possible, or if you get time, then you can go for the 10 years, at least 10 years question bank to solve. The fifth tip, basically, friends, is to make notes of all numericals from each chapter. If you go through the different chapters, friends, you will see there are different type of numericals in each chapters. So what I will suggest, like suppose you can make note of all these numericals in only one notebook, and then this will help you out to basically focus. If you want to focus on numerical part, so these are all the numericals you jot down in one notebook from different chapters, and then you can easily get an understanding of the different type of numericals that appears in the exam and how you need to solve those numericals. And the regular practice will also help you to solve even the tough numericals or a different type of numericals that will appear in your exam. So please note down all the numericals in one from each chapters in one single notebook, and try to solve it or try to practice it as many times as possible. So this is the fifth tip from my side, friends, for your reference. Tip number six, basically, friends, what I suggest is no need to refer any other books. BW gives you four books to read. I feel personally feel these four books are sufficient for the exam. There are a lot of candidates who really refer too many books and they get confused. I mean, they try to refer different books from. You can Google it out. You can if you wish to read, there is no restriction for reading. I mean, for better understanding, you can go through different books also if you feel like. But from my experience or from as per my understanding, there is no need to refer any other books because all the questions that are coming in the exam are based on only on those four books that are provided to you. So all the exam pattern or all the type of exam questions will be based on those books only. There won't be any other. Questions from other books or other subject matters. So basically, I would suggest you to not to think too much, not to refer any other book. If you wish, you can refer it, but not too much, and just focus on all the four books that you have received from BWE. All the question papers are going to, and the questions are coming going to come from all these four books and no other books, friends. So please refer only these books which you have received. And for better understanding, you can go anytime. You can go refer any other books, but for examination point of view, these four books are sufficient for your friends. So this is my first 6th tip. I mean, you don't need to refer any other books. If you wish, you can only take help of some books, but majorly you focus on these four books, and these books are really sufficient for you for to qualify the BWE exam, energy manager exam, or energy auditor exam. And now the tip number 7 and the last tip. Basically, friend, as I said earlier, you need not take any leave to prepare for this exam. Basically, what you need to do is at least spend 2 to 3 hours daily for preparation of this exam, and that is sufficient for you. To prepare yourself for the exam. No need to take any leaves. Just spend 2 to 3 hours daily, and this is my tip number 7 as a final tip, friends. So that's all for today, friends. Basically, I feel this video will help you out to prepare for this exam. You like this video, and really, if you feel this video is worthwhile, please share this with your friends, and also please connect with me. My personal email ID is chandansudeep07@gmail.com. You can straight away connect with me on this email ID. You can send me any queries if you have, if you want any support from my side. If you have any suggestions on this video or any way, if you want to suggest me something, please do connect with me. This is my email ID, friends. Also, this is my WhatsApp number. If you want to have some questions in your mind on this video, if you want to ask me something, straight away you can call me on this number. This is my mobile number. Also, this is my WhatsApp number. You can message me on this WhatsApp number. Whatever possible, I'll try to suggest you or help you out. Also, you can go through my website, that is takegreensteps.com. It's a basically a blog website, so you can go through the website, refer to some of the blogs that I have already posted on this website, and please do subscribe my channel, friends. This will motivate me to make more such videos in coming days. Also press the bell icon so that any notification, if you any new videos I post, straight away you get a notification and you can watch the videos. So basically, I'm going to make this type of videos in coming days, which will be really interesting for you to understand, for you to learn something. And hopefully, even this particular video that I have posted today, maybe this may help you to prepare for this exam. So also, please, I would like to request you to not only subscribe and press the bell icon, also please share this video to your friends, to your colleagues who are looking forward to appear for this exam in this year, also maybe in the coming years. So maybe this video can help them also in any way. So please, if you feel this video is worthwhile, please do subscribe my channel, also press the bell icon for notifications, and also please do share as many people you can. Thank you for watching this video, friends. Really, thanks again.